one revolution. Bookmarklets on standby.
Log online, fan page loaded and ready.
Player stats loaded. Health check, go.
Weapons check. Ice check, please.
We have launched for the Informant Podcast in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Welcome to this episode of the Informant Podcast, your new source for information regarding Mafia Wars from Zynga. I'm Pistol Pete from Spockholm.
Live long and prosper.
We have Janna, Mig, Death by Gucci, and Jennifer, the Mafia Wars lady.
Hello.
How's it going, guys?
Hi.
Mr. Chester's taking the night off again.
I know, I'm starting to get a complex.
I know, maybe he doesn't like us anymore.
That's what I'm worried about.
Oh, I think he was trying to make it tonight, and then just things came up.
Exactly. We just finished Christmas, you know. Some people have a lot going on.
Yep.
Our and Christmas we do make up. Fun of him a lot, so maybe
we do.
He needed a break from it.
He needed a reprieve from the torture.
Yeah. See what happens when he comes back.
But we love him, even though we call him names.
Yep. Yes, we miss you. So, there.
So, did everybody have a good Christmas? Get lots of toys and gifts and things they wanted?
Oh my gosh, I'm in Lego hell here.
Are you really?
Yes. My son got so much Atlantis Lego stuff. He got one that has 1,200 pieces.
Nice.
That's pretty much consumed my day today.
My boy's got a lot of Lego stuff. Mission from Mars.
Oh my gosh. Yep.
City.
And Star Wars, we got some...
Star Wars, yeah. Yes. Some Star Wars ones. My son got Lego Universe.
Oh, is that cool? I've heard that's really cool.
Yeah, he's pretty excited about it.
Yeah, I have to check that out pretty soon. Can you play it on a PC, or is it a game that you
PC
have to buy?
PC or Mac, and it's internet-based, so...
Okay, so... But anyway, how about you? Did you have a lot of fun? Family or anything?
I did, but I got some bad news. My stepdad, who's been sick a while, has passed, so I'm
oh,
gonna...
Gosh.
Return.
I'm sorry.
The show, head out on a plane, and I'll be out in New York most of the week. Coming back just in time for New Year's and go from there. So,
well, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yep.
Well, you'll be in my thoughts and prayers for sure.
Thank you.
If there's anything you need while you're gone, I can work over there at Spockholm. Maybe I can write a few scripts or whatever.
Oh, no.
Dish up a couple of scripts.
I could probably help you out. I don't know. It'd be interesting.
Yeah, so Spockholm's going to get a bit of a reprieve from me for this next week. I'll probably pop in just to answer some questions and stuff like that. But as far as anything else goes, you know, trying to write some new scripts or whatever, it's probably not going to happen. So,
well, family first.
That's right. So,
yeah.
Jennifer, did you have a lovely Christmas?
Oh, yes, I did. I went to Texas and my brother and his family came out. So we had a good time. No Legos, though, but we got the Star Wars Family Guy movie that just came out.
I saw that other day. Is it funny?
I did not watch it.
Oh, okay.
I'm just trying to be cool and say we got it. Because I like the Family Guy.
Oh, I bet. Yeah, I saw the little stand for it, but I didn't even know about it when it was being made. So probably be okay without seeing it.
Yeah.
A lot of stuff's been going on in Mafia Wars this week. Have you had a chance to keep up with all the
latest? A lot of stuff happened like earlier before the holiday, some good, some bad, some annoying. But the good thing we got was the search bar on the inventory page. So you can just type in the item you want and it'll take you right to it, which that's great.
Yeah, that helps.
Yeah.
Yeah, I could never find anything. And, you know, someone like me that's taking screenshots and wants to demonstrate on a blog, if I can't find something, so it was getting frustrating for me.
The only thing I still wish is that, how do you know, you know, what you got recently?
They fixed that too. If you go to your profile page, they added the old profile page back. So you have like that big mess of all the loot items you own.
Well, that's not what we wanted though.
But it's close enough. You just go to the last picture and that's the last item you
got. No, I get that, but I don't know why they just didn't add a drop down option for most recent.
But it is most recent.
Huh?
But like a drop-down menu that specifically says most recent.
What we like about the new inventory is that you have some control. You can see the items you can get from there. You can do some things right from that inventory page. So there are some elements of the new inventory page we like. What would be nice is that from that same inventory page, you now have an option to see the most recent, and it shows in the same format as the rest of the inventory page, not the old profile page that shows them in a big mass dump. See what I'm saying? Or not following me still?
Yeah,
I gotcha.
So for us that are getting used to now understanding the new inventory page, we just want a drop-down option that says most recent and then orders all of your gifts in reverse, you know, chronological order. So all your newest items show first, and then all your oldest items you've ever, you know, ever earned or found show up later on down the list.
Well, I have an idea, Pete.
Yo.
You could go to the forum boards and give your suggestion because they are working on feedback to evolve the feature.
I've just given them feedback, and my voice is more powerful than my words.
True,
although they do say that the pen is mightier than the sword.
We did discuss
but
this.
But I have to read
then
if I go to the forum to find the right place to post it.
And I know, Pete
and people
like
know
to
about
read.
Me as I'm horrible about reading.
Well, while we're on the topic of inventory, I have some exciting news to report. I kind of hinted about it in San Francisco about how they mentioned that we're going to get a pawn shop. And someone, Toenail Sin from the Mafia Wars Wiki, got an image of what it's going to look like. And it's going to be called Trader Goes. And it's a picture of an Asian gentleman. It has the Bangkok colors. And so that's kind of exciting.
Hmm.
And I did see, when I was in San Francisco and I got the tour, they did show me some images of it. And it, you know, I think it's going to be really exciting. And they were really excited about it too. So I don't quite know what we're going to get to do, but I know we'll get to trade in loot we don't need anymore, our inactive loot, and get better items. And I'm not sure if it's going to be, you know, items that are already available, or are there going to be special items just for trading with yourself?
Anything else? Did you get all of your presents collected for your tree and everything?
I did, and somebody stole four of them today. So I had, and all my protectors got used, so I had to ask for more. And then I opened up some holiday sacks, and I got my presents back to 45.
Oh, good.
I think people need to save a chunk of those holiday sacks for, like, the night before, just to make sure you have your 45 and you have your protectors. So when you wake up on New Year's Day, you'll be able to open 45 presents.
Yeah, otherwise you're up a creek.
Yeah, I'll be pissed off if someone steals them right before and I only get like 42.
Well, Jennifer, did you hear about any? I had the problem where I couldn't ask more people for help. I was getting an error message that said, oh, I can't even remember what it said, but something like I had reached
feed limit.
My feed limit, yes. Yep. And so I had to go into my privacy settings and remove part of the application. And that seemed to do the trick. I had to get walked through that. I had no idea. I didn't know if a lot of people were having that problem.
Jose Perez actually wrote a good note on how to do that. And it was a big issue. Customer support updated their 411 page with some hints. And I've just been doing the copy link where you post to somebody's wall and then go to that link and right click on it, copy link location, make a tiny URL and then post it to your wall. So people just have to click on it.
Yeah. Just I had a lot of gifts stolen. Yeah.
Well, it made me even more mad. And I talked to Jen about this earlier, that it just frustrates me that, you know, if you got your protectors, I didn't realize that when they did their job once, they disappeared.
I didn't either.
And so I was going through thinking I had six protectors and I was safe.
Yeah, you're
and
good.
And then all of a sudden I come back in and they're gone. And I'm like, what in the world is going on? Because nowhere in the description of the event, if you click the little question mark that it tells you about the event, does it say that you lose your protectors after they've done their job once?
It actually did say that on the pop-up that you got the very first time you did it.
Oh.
And since you don't read my blog...
And I don't read the pop-ups.
Doesn't read the pop-ups either. Don't feel bad.
I have to go read your blog now, I guess.
And well, you got to find the very first one.
Yeah.
And also, if you would read the customer support 411 pages.
Oh my God, you want me to read all this stuff? How am I going to get anything done?
He's working as hard as he can just to not be a click monkey.
I know. Well, actually, we'd rather have you make bookmarklets than read our stuff. So.
Yeah, we owe him that. We just have to tell him.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Yeah, but that threw me for a loop because I thought I was done and
you
safe.
You thought you
and
were
like,
good.
Cool. And then and then all of a sudden, I'm now disappearing. I had like 6 protectors and they're all gone.
I know. Yeah. I thought someone stole them, too.
I'm like starting all over again. Oh, boy.
I had to do it 3 times so far. But if you're stronger, this is where it's a benefit to have good defenses, even though the robbing equation's a little jacked up. You know, the stronger you are, if you lose and if they attack you and you lose, then you're not going to lose your protector.
Right, right.
So
we should gain one of their gifts, though.
Yeah, and hey, there's the other thing. Okay, so you get these gifts, and now you got these sacks, and you've already got your tree filled, and you get lumps of coal from your family that's being generous and giving you gifts.
I know.
Could they not
a
pick
insulting?
A better gift?
I know. It's almost like getting a hand buzzer.
Well,
yeah.
Trader Go may take care of you.
I could get rid of all my lumps of coal. Maybe I can run it through the armory and smelt it and turn it into some diamonds.
Yeah.
Well, they do look like little like dinosaur poop. So maybe you can make
Godzilla
diamonds out of poop.
I don't know.
And there's 2 different kinds of coal, too, if you notice that.
Yeah, well, there's the old one that's the actual one with the bow on top that's like the old, that was from last year's gifts.
The gift safe house with the crime spree.
That's right, and then they have the new one that's the 3 lumps of Godzilla poop.
Yeah.
But it just irritates me. I was like, you couldn't pick something? Give me a, you know, a star or give me an ornament that I can collect or something, even though
or even a smiley face just to make you feel better.
Yeah, how about a smiley face ornament?
Yeah, there you go.
I'm curious to see, like, how many good loot items we're going to get versus the crap that's not going to help you.
Yeah.
And I'm going to be mad if it's, like, if I get 1 good item.
So we open these presents on the 31st or the 1st?
The 1st.
Okay. All right.
And people can rob you up until then. So you really want to make sure, I know instead of going out and celebrating New Year's Eve, you might want to stay home and make sure your presents are protected.
Yeah, no. Yeah. I think I'll take that risk.
I'm just joking.
Good. That was a close one.
Yes. One more exciting thing. Well, I wouldn't say it's exciting. It was more annoying, but I guess for people that have finished everything, it's a good thing. But Atlantic City now has chapter 3, and it's the same as you have to unlock the bronze level of chapter 2 to get to chapter 3. And when you master it, you get a pretty cool loot item. But you have to master the bronze. This is new as well. Before it didn't matter. You have to master the bronze level to unlock chapter 2. And the bronze level of chapter 2 to unlock chapter 3. That's something new.
Well, they're just so tedious and boring.
They take up way too much energy and they don't do anything.
Well, I came back into my Atlantic City and found that I had 2 of my jobs that had already been completed to 100% down to 50%.
Mike and I had the same problem.
Did
and
you?
Mike went to customer support and they completed it for him and gave him skill points.
Sweet.
Yeah, you and me did it on our own, and if you paid attention
and
to
I got
skills,
nothing.
We got nothing, yeah, because I took screenshots before and after. I did not get any skill points.
Yep.
Pete also, or Martin, I don't know which one of you wrote it. I think Martin did, but there's a repeat job now for Atlantic City, which is cool when you get to the Ruby level, because it's only 2% mastery a click.
Yep. Does take a while.
And it's nothing fancy. There's no logging of anything. It just clicks for you. You
yep.
can
save those connect. Click monkeys.
Yeah.
Waiting on the shirts.
Yeah. And you don't have to unframe either, so it's a very easy bookmarklet to use. You just click it.
Yep.
So, hey, Pete, do you have any shout-outs you want to give out this week?
Yeah, I'd like to just take a moment and give a blanket shout-out to all the fans of Spockholm, the Mafia Wars Loot Lady page, to Meg. I got the Meg in
you did
before
good job.
You and Chester. To just all of our listeners, you know, we truly appreciate everybody. If you find anything that we missed or you'd still like us to hit on, don't forget to get in contact with us. You know, you're always welcome to reach us via email at tip@informantpodcast.com. You can go ahead and find us on the web at informantpodcast.com.
Oh, don't forget our rant line. It's been kind of quiet. That's 707-847-6852 or 707-TIP-6852.
Yep. So if you have anything, just let us know. Keep listening. We'll keep dishing out the information. We hope to have some more events coming up here in the future. Oh, and then the other thing to remind everybody about is that we do have our, as we get up to 4,000 fans, we will be giving away another lotto set. And then we have some new guests that will show up here in the next couple of weeks with regard to the show. So that ought to be interesting. I'll leave it at that for now. Big secrets. You've been listening to the Informant Podcast, where family is first. Thanks for listening. I wanna cause